FM News. On point.
Take a look at the news. I'm Lynn Combisha. President Yoweri Museveni has asked residents around mountainous areas to stop building permanent houses on the mountain because they fall victim to landslides. The president, who was canvassing for votes in Mbale district, said Mount Rwenzori and other related features should be used as tourist attractions for the region.
Well, I am glad people are now persuaded about the disasters. You remember when we were arguing with some of our people, they were trying to say, oh, you know, the Bamasava must go to the hills to look for Malewa. They say, yes, they can go and look, but they shouldn't stay there. I totally agree that we should have a serious urbanization plan where people can be in the lowlands around these factories. Because these factories are part of the attractions. Yes, and then with tourism for the hills. If we let the top of the mountain be like a forest and the steep slopes and the cliffs, then you will be having settlements in the lowlands earning the money from the forest mountain.
Museveni promised to construct various roads in Mbale and extending financial assistance towards the construction of the palace for the traditional leader.
And then Nalugugu Road, that one is going to be worked on. Then the 300 kilometers, that's all right, we can work, because we work. If you take the road from Oruyo that crosses the whole of Achori, I think it must be more than this, because it is from southwest to northeast of Achori. So 300 kilometers is not much. Although the terrain is a bit more difficult, but some parts of Masaba are in the lowlands. Now, about the palace of the Bamasaba, definitely we shall make a contribution. About the jobs for the Bamasaba, I will be looking out whenever there are some good jobs and there are good Bamasaba, I will put them there, no problem. And if the Bamasaba vote 90%, the encouragement will be greater. The Church of Uganda versus the garages, I think that one we handled. I don't know why it has taken long, but we should compensate the garage people and they go away.
Police in Masindi town has again blocked presidential candidate General Henry Tumukunde from speaking to his supporters this afternoon. Tumukunde is winding up his campaigns in the Bunyoro region, with the Chiriandongo district was supposed to speak to his supporters in Masindi at Colpin Hotel, but police did not allow him to access it. Speaking about the incident, General Tumukunde decried the continued disruption of his rallies by security agencies.
I don't know what exactly is happening. I think these people get different briefs. We had a discussion with the chief of police of Masindi. He talked with my team. I remember them communicating everything to me as being smooth. So I don't know what exactly happened. We are just simply being stopped even from going to our venue. So those are the circumstances. I don't know what the issues are. Where, I don't know about whether we can achieve our goals in these circumstances. It's becoming very difficult to access people. Even venues, whatever we are supposed to do, you can't reach. Like we had a venue in Colpin, they just simply obstacled. Now I don't know where my coordinators are. I don't know where the group which was meant to meet me is. So those are the circumstances.
Uganda Wildlife Authority started the process of relocating the marabou stocks to Parliament, as well as a complaint by State Minister for Mineral Development, Sarah Opendi, over the stench from the birds she says might be harmful to human health, and asked Parliament to consider relocating them. The wildlife team, accompanied by KCC, a team climbed the trees and picked the eggs, rescued nestlings of marabou stocks, cattle, egrets, and destroyed the nests. The officer in charge of problem animals at Wildlife Authority Venice Mirembe says what they're doing is taking the nestlings and destroying the nests in the hope that the birds will go away. She also says that the team will be returning Friday to finalize the work that has been hindered by branches.
The people who were supposed to come and reduce the branches were, I think, already in the field. They were not anticipating reduction of the branches, but they will still do the cutting. So the chicks will be taken to Uganda Wildlife Education Center for better management.
In other news, Tanzania's opposition leader Tundu Lissu has urged the international community to impose sanctions against state officials linked to human rights abuses in last month's disputed general elections. President John Pombe Magufuli won a second term in the election that was marred with violence and claims of fraud. The UK and United States said there had been systematic interference, but the Tanzania's Electoral Commission says there was no fraud. Mr. Lissu, in a tweet, called on the international community to impose targeted sanctions, asset freezes, travel bans, and such measures as are necessary to end the impunity. The opposition leader fled to Belgium soon after the election, citing threats to his life. The government said there was no evidence of threats to opposition leaders. In entertainment news, the Recording Academy and CBS have announced that comedian Trevor Noah, host of Comedy Central's Emmy Award-winning Daily Show, will host the 63rd Annual Grammys Awards. The announcement comes hours before Tuesday's 63rd Grammy Awards nominations live stream on Grammy.com at 9 a.m. And despite the fact that I am extremely disappointed that the Grammys have refused to have me sing or be nominated for Best Pop Album, I'm thrilled to be hosting this auspicious event, said Noah. I think as a one-time Grammy nominee, I'm the best person to provide a shoulder to all the amazing artists who do not win on the night, because I too know the pain of not winning the award. That was the news.
XFM News on point.